Welcome back, students. We were seeing the topic molecular basis of inheritance, and now let's see another structure of DNA which was proposed by Watson and Crick. Now Watson and Crick, these were the scientists which discovered the correct structure of DNA in 1953. Their double helix model of DNA structure was based on the two major evidences, which were the Chargaff's rule and X-ray diffraction patterns. Now Watson and Crick proposed that DNA exists as double helix, in which the two polynucleotide chains are coiled one above the other like a spiral. As you can see in the picture, it looks like a spiral. Each polynucleotide chain consists of a sequence of nucleotide linked by the phosphodiester bond. As you can see here, they are linked by the phosphodiester linkage. As you can see here, there is phosphodiester linkage between the every two polynucleotide chain. The two polynucleotide strands are held together in their helical configurations by the hydrogen bonding. As you can see here, this is the hydrogen bonding. The base pairing is specific, that is, the adenine is always paired with thymine and guanine is always paired with cytosine. Thus, all the base pairs consist of one purine and one pyrimidine. That means A pairs with T and G pairs with C. Now, once the sequence of bases in the one strand of DNA helix is known, it is possible to know the other strand sequence of the base because of the specific pairing. Now, hydrogen bonding is just like that. Two hydrogen bonds are present between A and T, that is adenine and thymine, while between guanine and cytosine, three hydrogen bonds are present. As you can see here, the DNA has double helix structure. The one turn is of 3.4 nm and one nucleotide, the distance between two nucleotide is 0.434 nm. Okay. The diameter of complete DNA molecule is about 2 nm. The first end is 5 prime end and the second end is called as 3 prime end, where the 3 hydroxyl group is attached and 5 prime end has the 5 prime phosphate group, which is paired with, so 5 prime end is always paired with 3 prime end and 3 prime end is always paired with 5 prime end. Students, in this session we have seen the DNA double helix structure. In further session we will have a more detailed look.